installation and commissioning. Low to medium kVA canopy gensets. Proper installation and commissioning of a genset is very important to achieve better uptime and safety. This video acts as a guide to a typical genset installation. Please note, there may be some variables in actual condition. Government of India regulations have made it mandatory for genset manufacturing plants to ensure a proper enclosure called canopy for all gensets manufactured in their plants. Each genset should be CPCP compliant. Canopy gensets can be placed in open air. Foundation. Before the arrival of the DG set, ensure a cement concrete foundation block of adequate size is made ready for placing the genset. Length and breadth minimum 12 inches more than the DG set. Depth of the concrete block . The neutral earth pits and body earth pits should be located on opposite sides of the canopy. Two earthing pits for body earthing, one from the alternator body and the other from the canopy. Two separate earthing pits for the neutral. Connect the two neutral plates to form a neutral earth grid. Similarly, connect the body earth plates to form a body earth grid. Note that the body and neutral earth should never be interconnected. Chemical earthing. Chemical earthing is strongly recommended in those locations where water level is low. Soil resistivity is high, mostly in hilly terrains. It is better than conventional salt charcoal earthing in many ways. It is maintenance free. No need to pour water regularly as in the charcoal and salt method. It has a very long life. Drill a bore of 200 to 300 mm diameter and 2 to 3 meter depth. Insert the earthing electrode at the center of the bore. Mix the chemical compound nicely with water to make a thick slurry. Pour it around the sides of the electrode gradually to reach up to the ground level. First check of earth resistance value will be carried out on the day of the installation. Final results are taken 7 days after installation. The earthing electrode can now be connected after the preliminary check. Unloading. To lift the genset, use the hook provided on the canopy. Ensure that the lifting tackle is of sufficient strength for the DG load. Keep all personnel away from the DG set when in suspended position. Ensure the DG set is placed exactly at the center of the foundation so that uniform gap is maintained on all sides of the DG set. Genset should be placed considering wind direction and there should be no obstruction to natural wind flow. Ensure that the opening provided for fresh air inlet and hot air outlet are not blocked. leave adequate space around for easy access to attend to the engine and genset's servicing needs. It is recommended that minimum 1 meter space be available on all sides. While placing the genset on the foundation, consider natural wind flow and place the genset in such a way that the natural wind flow and the generator fan wind throw direction are the same. Fresh air from the alternator side enters inside the canopy and hot air is blown out by the pusher fan from the radiator side. The direction of exhaust gas discharge should be the same as the radiator air through direction. The difference between ambient temperature outside the canopy and that inside the canopy should not be more than 7 degrees. The gases must never enter back into the genset or enter into windows, doors or any such other areas. Improper ventilation will result in overheating of the genset, affecting its performance that may lead to higher fuel consumption. Take care to see that genset should be located away from polluted atmosphere. For humid or coastal atmospheric applications, anti-condensation heaters are recommended for alternator. General checks. Visually check the canopy for any damages and check the door locks. Visually check the base frame. Fix all parts which comes loose along with the genset. Align and fasten the exhaust bellows if required. Check the tightness of the AVM pad bolts, base frame bolts and radiator mounting bolts. Exhaust piping. Ensure that exhaust gas goes out to the atmosphere without obstruction. Exhaust piping run to rooftop should be through sound attenuated ducting. If additional exhaust piping is required, the exhaust pipe length should be as short as possible. Keep the number of bends minimum to ensure minimum back pressure. Excessive back pressure will result in poor engine performance. Always use smooth bends. Have a look at the table of bends. After noting down the number of bends and type of bends involved, calculate the total equivalent length. Earthing. Copper or GI strip of suitable size should be used for earthing. Now test the earthing condition. To measure the earthing condition, use only an earth tester. Using the earth tester. In this method, two separate spikes are driven in the earth. Spike length into the earth should not be more than 1/20th of the distance between two spikes. These two spikes are kept in the same line, due to which there will not be mutual interference in the field of individual spikes. Pour water for good conductivity. Now, earth tester terminals C1 and P1 are shorted to each other and connected to earth electrode under test. Terminals P2 and C2 are connected to two separate spikes driven in the earth. If we rotate the generator handle with specific speed, we get directly earth resistance on scale. Please note, earthing condition test should be done only with earth tester. If you use a multimeter, it will create continuity and not the actual health of the earth bit. Ensure that continuity and resistance tests of the earth bits are conducted at least once in a year. Cabling. Check the alternator visually. Check AVR connections. Care to be taken that weights of cables should not fall on the alternator. Crimped cables should be connected to alternator and control panel through cable glands. Check all cables. Clean, tighten and apply petroleum gel. Ensure that the battery is fully charged. Make sure that the polarity of the battery connections are correct before applying power to all electronic controls. Power cabling between alternator and control panel and changeover switch, two mains, should be done with correct size of cables and thimbles. It is very important to select the correct size of load cables. Refer the chart. Engine checks. Check the lube oil level using the dipstick. Visually check the coolant level. If low, top up as required. Visually check the radiator. Ensure free flow of air. Air bleeding. To ensure that the fuel system is free of any entrapped air, perform bleeding from fuel filters and FIP. Starting the engine. Start the engine in the manual mode and let the DG operate for 2-3 minutes with no load. Check for leakages from radiator hoses. Leakage from exhaust. Make sure that cables and hoses are not rubbing against anything. Check working of all meters, lamps and indicators. Note down the performance parameters, RPM, frequency, voltage. Check the oil pressure and water temperature. Check for any abnormal noise or vibration. Use a sound level meter, commonly known as dB meter, to measure the sound level. Note, in open air canopy type gensets, you have to measure noise level as per the Ministry of Environment and Forests. DG sound level at 1 meter distance from canopy should not be more than 75 dB. Stop the engine and check the working of the stop solenoid. It should hold for 15 seconds. Applying load on the DG. Never start the genset with 100% load. It is advisable to apply load in steps. Check proper distribution of load on all the phases. Note down all the parameters. Now, if the genset has been provided with an AMF panel, set the DG in auto mode and check the performance parameters. Also check the working of all alarms, LLOP, HWT, LFL and RWL. check the auto mains failure operation. Now run the engine for at least 1 hour. Check all parameters once again. Ensure the proper working of the DG. To shut down the genset, turn off the load. Allow the DG set to run on no load for a few minutes. Then shut down.